Hello everybody, Keith here again. Going to have a look now at repotting one of the tallest of my orchids at least. This is the larger of my two Dendrobium nobly types, Lady Colman. You can see it in the background over my shoulder. It's quite a monster. I don't know how on earth I'm going to manage to video this, I really don't, but I'm going to do the best I can and hopefully we'll get something useful out of it. So I'll set the camera up for how I want it to be and we'll go from there. Okay, well I already had one accident this afternoon and knocked off the new growth, which was an absolute pain. It was developing nicely and it came away. I hope we're going to do this. It's because it's a tall plant. I really hope we're going to be able to see what I'm doing. It's so tall I have to keep the pot inside this earthenware sleeve, and as you said earlier on, even that didn't save it from falling over. And when I picked it up again, I realised that the new growth had been knocked off. Now, one thing I will show you while we get going is this. This is a metal stake which I've added to it. I've also got a wooden stake which I've strapped together with tie wraps just to try and get to this height of cane. I mean, just looking at it, that one cane, it's a heck of a thing. As I say, it's at least 2 feet long, so it's a real good length. So this is going to be interesting, I think, trying to take all these stakes out. That's the metal one. But it's a great big sprawling plant. Typical nobly type, of course, they do that, and I have to strap it up in all directions. Hopefully once it's been repotted I can do a better job of it, but this has been done. Turn it so you can see what I'm doing better. I'm just trying to unstrap all the various bits of wire that I've used. It's been here a little while. It's certainly grown extremely well. But it's flopped about all over the place, and just to try and get the centre of gravity back over the pot. I mean, you can see how it's just gone over from that. This year it's going to get extremely unstable. I don't want to risk knocking everything to bits if I'm not very careful. There's absolutely no sign that this is in any kind of distress. I'm just hoping that the fact I'm having to knock always another eye, so with a bit of luck, second eye, it's been in here too long. I can see that straight away because another stake I've missed there. Having to be very, very careful now, because this thing is flopping about in all directions. And I could very easily end up with doing more harm than good. See for a start how much it's developed. This was the plant I got a few years ago, one of the first plants I got through the East Midlands Orchid Society. And you can see what we end up with. There we go. Well, this is going to be fun. I think as far as this goes, all the way over there, you're not going to see anything very much at all. So, I think what I might do is change tripods and move it to where I normally have it, on the side of the table, and then you'll get a better view of this part of the process. Okay, that's better. You can see what was in the pot better here, and it's undoubtedly been in the pot a long time, which I knew, but I don't think the roots are that bad. Got a big tangle of them in the bottom of here, but I think it's likely to be fully capable of going back into the same pot. There are some dud roots, unsurprisingly, but for the most part I'm not really detecting anything much except poor stuff on the older part of the plant, which is exactly what you would expect, of course. There's a broken stake. No, it's been in here much too long. I think this is going to need to be soaked so that I can clean these up rather better than I've managed so far. What I've found is whatever they use to adhere the roots to the bark, or in nature of course the tree, is to some extent water soluble, certainly reduced effectiveness. So I think I get this into soak, we should be able to get some more of that out, and I'll be able to see what's happening a lot better than I can at the moment. So just hang on a minute. Right, all I've done is soaked it very, you know, in that little tub of rainwater, and I've got the roots pretty much untangled, and I've been able to get most of the old bark out without doing a lot of damage, and I can certainly see better where I've got to get it out. So, have I got much by way of bad roots. No, I haven't. This is in pretty good nick overall. We've got some that are not great. Well, there we are. That's always true. But even some of the old roots are still showing signs of active tips. One or two are broken, but I mean, fundamentally, you're not going to do a lot better than this one. I mean, even things like that, which is coming from right underneath the plant. I'll take that one off, I think. But even that, he's not looking that desperate. So that certainly explains why the orchid is looking reasonably healthy, because it's got some a healthy rootstock down in here. So, the nice weather brought the loonies out. I see. I mean, despite me being a motorcyclist for well over 50 years and still riding, don't appreciate anybody, cars or bikes, coming absolutely banging up outside out. It's supposed to be a 30 mile an hour limit, but they come up here like it was Donington Park or Brands Hatch. So I think, although it's not something I generally like to do, I think I'm going to take some of these longer, certainly some of these older long roots off. That doesn't feel terribly good. That can come off. That one, no, it's coming off another old root. So, okay, that's going to be pretty good, I think. That's quite a reasonable looking root system, all pretty firm. And that will go straight back into that pot where it's been before. And hopefully, one way or another, we can end up with a plant that will be okay for another few years. I can stop knocking everything all over the place. Right, a bark. It's been in some quite small stuff there. Being well, I'm going to go down to RHS Wisley very soon, and the idea is to them to bring me some medium bark, because I've got some coarse stuff, I've got some kind of a mixture, but I could do with something that's a bit in between. Right then, this is where it's all going to get extremely silly, I suspect. Cool off, good. Right. I think trying to get all this root in there, and then trying to get the bark in is going to prove a bit of a challenge. But let's see, that twisting thing is something that I've learnt through YouTube. I've got a feeling it was Roger, but I couldn't say for sure. But if you've got a long root, you don't want to pot it up a long way. If you twist it carefully, then the roots should move, and you can do better. It's really important, of course, that you get the roots well. Now, some people say it's a good idea to put some of the stakes, at least while you're doing the potting, in the hope that it will keep them better fastened. The metal one, which is the one that should be capable of propping a lot of it up now. That's something that Mel Stephen, one of our very long-standing members and Dendrobium specialist, suggested, that you get a plastic-coated metal stake. And I found them at a local garden centre as a pack of three. I don't find them that they're ever so common. I bought a pack of three, and they weren't terribly expensive, and of course they should last a lot better than wood. That inevitably rots just like the bark does. Trying to work out how I'm going to arrange all these canes is interesting. I'm kind of set them up one at a time, I think. Because I didn't think that I was going to be videoing from there. I didn't put the blackout curtain in up. So I'm afraid you're kind of getting it into the sun. But fundamentally, I'm just trying to strap at least part of this cane on here, and now I've got one up, I can look at doing any more. These are classed as soft cane dendrobium, so they are fairly flexible. You can sort of work with them a little bit to straighten them up, even if they try to grow over a bit. I think it's going to be fairly close to being it. unstable at the moment. So let's strap this cane up first and then go from there, I think. Similar height. So, kind of like persuade them to attach to this one. Not with that. These things get so big and heavy that sometimes all I can do is actually strap the various canes and things together, or the stakes and what have you, together, just to try and help keep them upright. I think I'll end up with a lot less staking than I did doing it ad hoc previously, but I don't think that it's going to be exactly a neat job. Tie those two stakes together. Hopefully, yes. The trouble is, of course, when you get something that's very tall but not very wide, it's inherently unstable. And presents a whole load of problems in its wake. If I can't manage to persuade it to work with me, I may have to call it quits and pass it on to somebody who's got a bit more room in his greenhouse than I've got in here. They are a bit of a nuisance, but my life's much more stable. It's much better. That is very much better than it was. I think those three can just be pulled together. There's nothing. They're on their way out, so next time it's repotted, they'll probably get snipped off. I'll just tie those together just to stop everything shackling about. Because apart from anything else, if it's sprawling about all over the shop, it's more likely to catch on something else, of course. So, we've now got away with two stakes instead of four or five. It looks a lot better. It should be happier in that, I think, than it was. It's much more stable than it was. Well, it's still not brilliant, as you can see from that. But it can go back into its pot, have a water, and we can call that a good job done. So I'm sorry this has not been a particularly brilliant video. Right, there it is. Got the pot in there, look, and it's all been strapped together, but it's still a big sprawling plant, as you can see, so it's not ideal. Anyway, thanks for watching. I hope that's been of interest, and I've hopefully been able to get rid of a lot of the shaky bits in the editing. Thanks for watching. See you soon. Bye.